The Philippine government moves to streamline drivers' access to tollways across Luzon. The Toll Regulatory Board says drivers will be able to register their Easy Trip RFIDs in auto-sweep tollways or those operated by the San Miguel Corporation starting January 15th. This means motorists can now use their Easy Trip cards to enter tollways that employ the auto-sweep system. This is the second phase of the government's toll interoperability efforts. The third phase aims to roll out one wallet for both toll systems.
Local officials looking into changing the carrying capacity allowed on Boracay Island as a world-famous destination is reportedly at risk of collapsing. That's after more than 800 sinkholes were found on the island, up from 789 4 years ago. The Mines and Geosciences Bureau has urged Boracay officials to ensure that the island's carrying capacity is observed. The mayor of Malay Town, where Boracay is located, says the island is currently receiving some 4,000 tourists a day. That's still within the allowed carrying capacity of 6,500. Local officials will meet with the Mines and Geosciences Bureau on December 21st to discuss mitigating measures.
Discuss kita within Arian kung ano ba dapat gawin. Maghingit ako ng mapa niyan sa MDB. Makikita natin sa mapa ay gaano kalaki yung mga sinkhole diyan. At least, tamaan natin, ma-regulate natin yung mga sakto dapat ilagay.
President Marcos has signed an executive order adjusting the percentage of net earnings to be declared by the Development Bank of the Philippines. Based on the EO, the percentage was adjusted from 50% of net earnings to 0% for calendar year 2021. The dividend law requires all government-owned or controlled corporations to declare and remit at least 50% of their annual net earnings to the national government. But the president, upon the recommendation of the finance secretary, may adjust the percentage of annual net earnings to be declared by a GOCC in the interest of the national economy. The finance secretary has recommended the downward adjustment in order to support DBP's capital position and sustain its role in the economic recovery of industries adversely affected by the pandemic.
Filipino consumers are more pessimistic in the fourth quarter due mainly to inflation. The Philippine Central Bank's confidence index declined to negative 14.6% this quarter, worse than the third quarter's negative 12.9%. The consumers who participated in the survey cited the faster increase in the prices of goods, low income, higher household expenses, and few working family members. Meanwhile, business confidence also weakened this quarter to 23.9% from 26.1% in the third quarter. The businesses cited the rising costs of raw materials, fuel, higher interest rates, and the peso's appreciation for the weaker sentiment. Both consumers and businesses also have a similar outlook for 2023, with some consumers holding off buying big-ticket items and some businesses holding off on expansion plans.
The European Council open to pursuing fresh trade deal talks with the Philippines. During a recent trip to Brussels, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. made a pitch for a free trade agreement between Manila and the European Union. He also pushed for the renewal of the country's Generalized Scheme of Preferences Plus or GSP Plus accreditation. According to the Office of the Press Secretary, the European Council's president said, the GSP Plus accreditation would open the doors for a much easier start in going into FTA negotiations. The EU earlier said the Philippines was included in the list of countries eligible for the renewal of the GSP Plus status as long as it implements 27 international core conventions on labor rights, human rights, good governance, and the environment. Meanwhile, negotiations for the FTA between the Philippines and the EU started in 2016. The last round of discussion was held in 2017.